Now in this session, we are going to discuss about the practical, which is related to the evaporation process, that is to determine the capacity of an open pan evaporator. Now we have discussed about the evaporation operation, that is the operation where we required to increase the concentration of thin liquor or the weak solution, and we have to get the thick liquor or the high concentrated solution. So our main aim is to increase the concentration from low concentrated liquor to high concentrated liquor by evaporating the solvent. So normally in most of the cases, water is a solvent. So we have to supply the heat. Normally in the industries, we are going to supply the heat as a lower pressure steam. So LPS is the heating media from which we can get the heat, and the weak solution or the thin liquor is gaining that heat, and after reaching the boiling point of solution, the water is going to evaporate, and then the remaining liquor is thick liquor as compared to the feed. So the applications may be in the sugar industries, the applications may be in the other industries where the evaporation process is required. The relevant program outcomes are, we have to apply the basic knowledge of science mathematics for the calculations and for applying some of the logic or the concepts. Then we have to apply the chemical engineering knowledge to solve the industry-based problems. Now in this case, we have to calculate the capacity of an evaporator. So we must know what exactly the capacity of the evaporator is. So that is the part of the chemical engineering knowledge. So capacity is nothing but the kg of water evaporated per hour. Then experiments and practices, that is plan to perform experiments and practices to use the results to solve the technical problems related to the chemical engineering. And then individual and teamwork and communication is needed. So we have to perform the practical or experiment in a team. So normally one of the student is going to handle about the theoretical part. Other students are going to handle about the practical aspects and calculations. So that requires teamwork, and that should be communicated effectively through other team members also. Then we have to apply the heat transfer principles to increase the efficiency and also to save the energy in the chemical process plants. So for that purpose, we have to apply these principles in the laboratory first, and then we can scale up these principle techniques to save the energy. Then the relevant course outcome is calculate the energy associated with an evaporator. So we have to calculate the energy associated with the evaporators. So what exactly we have supplied, what exactly the gain by that liquid or weak solution, and what are the radiation losses. Then practical outcome is using an open pan evaporator, determine the capacity of evaporator. So that is our main aim of this practical, is to calculate, to determine the capacity of evaporator. So capacity of evaporator is kg of water evaporated per hour. So how much quantity of water is going to evaporate within an hour, that is nothing but the capacity of evaporator. So this terminology decides the performance of an evaporator. So there are two parameters which are going to decide the performance of an evaporator, is capacity and economy. So one of the parameter is capacity. Then relevant affective domain related to the outcomes are, follow the safe practices, maintain the tools and equipments, demonstrate working as a leader or a team leader. Now this is the theoretical background which required. So some of the things we have already discussed, what exactly the evaporation is, then what is the solvent normally, that is water, and there are two parameters which decides the performance of evaporator, that is capacity and economy. So we have discussed about the capacity, that is kg of water evaporated per hour, and the economy is kg of water evaporated per kg of steam fed. So these two parameters are there. Now in this case, when we supply the heat to the equipment or to the pot or to the beaker, whatever we are going to use for this purpose, for this experiment, because this experiment is carried out as an open pan evaporator. So open pan may be a utensils, that may be a MS or stainless steel, or you can also use an open beaker also. So after supplying the heat, that may be a electrical supply or that may be a steam, that the heat is gained by that liquid or the solution to increase the temperature of the solution. And after reaching the temperature to its boiling point, that is, which is nothing but the solution's boiling point, then the part of the vaporization or evaporation is going to start. So the solvent vaporization or evaporation is done after some times. So there are two steps. So first step is to increase the temperature of the solution up to boiling point. And second step, the vaporization or evaporation of that solvent. So initially in the first step, increase in temperature without phase change is nothing but the sensible heat. And after boiling point, there is a change in phase, that is liquid to vapors. It means that is the part of latent heat. So this is the diagram which shows the open pan evaporator. So normally when you are going to use a standard open pan evaporator, so it looks like in this diagram. So this is the pan where the solution is there. This is the jacket. So in the standard open pan evaporator, normally we are providing the heat with the help of steam. So for that purpose, we required boiler arrangement and this steam provision. So there is a boiler, that is why this pressure gauge, temperature gauge, level indicator, all the mounting and accessories are provided. Then with the help of this boiler, we are going to generate this steam, and we have to provide this steam to the open pan evaporator with the help of this jacket arrangement. After gaining the latent heat from the steam by the solution, the steam is going to convert into condensate, right? So this latent heat is gained by the solution, and the temperature of the solution is increasing. So after reaching the boiling point of a solution, the solution is going to convert into vapors. That is, the part of solvent is going to convert into vapors. That is the evaporation process, right? So it is an open pan and the evaporation process is carried out. That is why it is called as open pan evaporator. Now our main aim is to calculate what exactly the rate of that evaporation is. So that rate is called as capacity of an evaporator, that is kg of water evaporated per hour. So we can also use the simple utensils, a beaker or whatever which can be heated. The resources required, that is open pan. Now in this case, whatever the utensils or beaker you are going to use, the dimensions of that particular resource, that may be a diameter height and weighing machine for measuring the initial weight and final weight. For measuring the initial and final weight, of the solution. So precautions for this practical, sir, pan should be clean before used, accurate weight should be taken, because on the basis of weight we can determine the capacity of an evaporator. So what exactly the procedure for this experiment is: clean the pan and find its weight, that is W1 gram. Then prepare a 10 to 20% of NaCl solution. So we have to add the NaCl solution. Suppose if you are going to prepare this 20% solution of NaCl, then for 100 gram or 100 ml water, we have to add 20 gram of NaCl. Likewise, then transfer the solution to the pan. Take the weight of the solution with pan, that is W2 gram. Then heat the solution using electrical heater or flame for 1 hour. Switch off the heater, then allow the solution to cool and note down the weight of the solutions. So initially the weight is W1 gram, that is the weight of pan. Then after adding the solution, it is W2 gram, and after an hour, because the capacity is kg of water evaporated per hour, so we have to operate this evaporator for 1 hour. And after 1 hour, we have to observe the readings, that is W3, right? So on the basis of this W3 and W2, because only water is going to evaporate, so after an hour, whatever the amount of water is evaporated, that should be minus from the initial weight. And then we can conclude that this much of water, or the kg of water evaporated per hour, that is the capacity. So for in this table, we have to write the actual resources, the actual company details and the quantity. Then the actual procedure followed should be written in this 13th point. The precautions, that is the actual precautions followed by staff and students, should be written in this 14th point. And the observations, that is W1 gram initial weight of pan in kg, weight of pan and dilute solution, that is W2 in kg, then weight of pan and concentrated solution W3 kg, that is after an hour, this W3 is there, and we have to calculate the water evaporated. So this W3, that is after an hour, and W2. So whatever the difference between these initial and final weight, that should be noted down in the kg, and we can write the capacity of an evaporator for an hour, that is in terms of kg per hour. That is the simple procedure and experiment for this open type or open pan evaporator. So you can interpret the results, you can conclude with one or more sentences, and you can verify this learning of this open pan evaporator by solving the solution like questions: define evaporation, list the properties of solution which affect evaporation operation, define capacity and economy of evaporator, how evaporation is different from drying. Thank you. Now we will observe how to demonstrate this practical. So for that purpose, I will show you the simple
apparatus so this is the simple requirement for this open pan evaporator so we required a heating supply so that heating supply may be a electrical supply or maybe a gas flame right so we have taken a beaker as a open pan and now the temperature is set at 80 degrees celsius so you can observe this temperature and you can also observe the boiling is taking place in this pan now in this pan we have taken 400 ml water that is equivalent to 400 gram and we have added 80 grams of NaCl so that is 20% solution is prepared and now it is boiling so after an hour we will check the weight that is nothing but W3 we have note down the W1 and W2 grams and we have to convert it into kgs so after an hour the W3 can be note down and with the help of this W3 and W2 difference we can calculate the capacity of an evaporator so this is a simple practical or the experiment thank you